Hello, church. Good morning and Calvary greetings. And above all, happy Easter. I do hope that you and your family continue to stay safe, blessed, and highly favored. This continue to be interesting times indeed, with the lockdown, with the social distancing, and so on. But I want to assure you, with the word of God in Psalm 121, verse 1 to 2. It says, I will lift up my eyes to the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, who made the heaven and the earth. Even in this season of lockdown, of economic issues, challenges, I join my faith with yours and that of your family, that no evil shall come near you. God Almighty in his miraculous way shall supply your need in the mighty name of Jesus. So the church buildings are still closed just because the government has wisely decided that public gatherings for now should be avoided so that the virus does not spread further. So this is for our good. So the buildings are closed, but the church is open, alive, and well. So I welcome you to church this Easter Sunday. And I say welcome to church because it does not matter whether we are meeting on Facebook, whether we are meeting on YouTube or on Twitter or Instagram, however we choose to meet, we know that God is with us. Because he said in his word, in Matthew 18, verse 20, where two or three are gathered together in my name, there I am in their midst. The Lord is with us right now. So I want you to believe that wherever you are right now, God Almighty is with you. God will touch you, God will bless you, and God will do something great in your life today. On this special Easter day, God will make you to experience the power of resurrection. So please gather your family together, dress up for church the way you normally do. Pick up your Bible, pick up your instrument of praise, and together, let's gather and worship the Lord. So if you can, right where you are, I ask that you please go on your knees as we take some worship song from Covenant Voices to lead us into this Easter Sunday. God bless you.
And forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh,
Attention, avoid any kind of distraction, listen to the message, and the message inside the message. When you hear your own word, you say a loud amen, you write it down, and you turn it into prayers. I'm joining my faith with yours, that just as you believe, may God Almighty do unto you. In Jesus' name, amen. Almighty Father, on this special Easter Day celebration, I commit myself into your hands afresh, O God. Please fill me, fill my mouth with your word. Bless your people and take all the glory. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed. Amen. May I please ask that you rise on your feet and you lift up your Bible as we take the affirmation together. This is my Bible. I am what it says I am. I have what it says I have. I can do what it says I can do. I am about to receive the incorruptible, indestructible, eternal seed of the Word of God. My mind is alert. My heart is receptive. I will never be the same again. Never, never, never. I will never be the same again in Jesus' name. Amen. And while still standing, may I please ask that you open with me to Matthew chapter 28, and I will read verse 1 to verse 6. Matthew 28, verse 1 to 6. In the end of the Sabbath, as it began to dawn towards the first day of the week, came Mary Magdalene and the other Mary to see the sepulchre. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat upon it. His countenance was like lightning, and his raiment white as snow. And for fear of him, the keepers did shake and became as dead men. And the angel answered and said unto the women, "Fear not, for I know that ye seek Jesus, which was crucified. He is not here. He is risen. As he said, come, see the place where the Lord lay." Beloved, I can sense it already, that the power of resurrection is about to do something mighty in your life. This sermon was laid in my heart by the Holy Spirit just a few days ago, and it is titled, "Come and See." Come and see. Please, let's take this song together as we go into the Word and invite the Holy Spirit himself to take absolute control. The song says, "Lord, I lift your name on high."
Your name on high, Lord, I love you.
Father. You came from heaven to earth. Your name on high, even as we go, Lord, into your word. Father, breathe upon your word in the mighty name of Jesus. Meet every one of us, oh God, at the points of our needs. Do something new, do something great, do something powerful. Let the power of resurrection, Lord, be manifest in our lives. Thank you, everlasting Father, in Jesus' mighty name. We have prayed. Amen. God bless you. Please take your seat. Come and see. I pray for you even before going into the sermon that people will soon be calling themselves to come and see the mighty work of God in your life in Jesus' name. I say it one more time. Very soon, people will be calling themselves to come and see the mighty work of God in your life, in Jesus' name. Amen. A few points that we'll be able to take today as the Holy Spirit unfolded the sermon to me. I knew there's no way we can finish today. So wherever we get into, we'll continue when next God gives us the opportunity to fellowship together. But for today, number one, may God cause a shaking in your favor. May God cause a shaking in your favor. The resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ began with a shaking. Open with me one more time to that Matthew chapter 28, verse 2. Matthew 28, verse 2. It said, and behold, there was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat on it. So the resurrection miracle began with a shaking. I pray for you from the bottom of my heart that God will cause a shaking in your favor in Jesus' name. Ezekiel 22, verse 27. Ezekiel 21, verse 27. It says, I will overturn and overturn and overturn, and it shall be no more until he whose right is it, and I shall give it to him. In other words, God is saying, I will continue to shake it. I will continue to shake. I will continue to shake everything until the person I intend to bless manifests, and I shall release unto him or her. I pray for you from the bottom of my heart that all around you, God will continue to cause a shaking. He will continue to cause a shaking. He will continue to cause a shaking until you are favored in Jesus' name. Amen. I pray one more time for somebody. You are hearing this word right now. I pray that God will shake everything around you, in your business, in your family, in your head, everything that concerns you, God Almighty will shake it until you receive your blessing in the mighty name of Jesus. Number two, may God send help to you from heaven. I say it one more time. May God send help to you from heaven. So the story of the resurrection is a very powerful one. Because everybody that could help Jesus on earth, they ran away and left him stranded. Don't worry, people are leaving you stranded. Don't be bothered if the people you expect to come to your help are not picking your calls. Don't worry at all. The judge who knew that Jesus did not do anything wrong, and he had the power to set Jesus free. But because of his own life, he chose to set an armed robber free and to deliver Jesus into the hands of murderers. The judge ran for his life. The disciples of Jesus that were with him for 3 years of the ministry, when the day of trouble came, they ran away. The relatives of Jesus, his own family, when the day of trouble came, they ran away. The friends of Jesus, they ran away. And even very sadly enough, the congregation, the church, ran away. Because the Bible said when Jesus was still alive, still preaching, everywhere he went, multitudes followed him. They wanted to get the healing. They wanted to hear the word. Everywhere he went, thousands followed him. But on the day of trouble, he was alone. I prophesy upon your life. Even when everybody disappears and deserts you, God Almighty will send help from heaven. I say it one more time. When the people who are supposed to help you, when they refuse to come to your help, God Almighty will send help from heaven in Jesus' name. He said there was a shaking and God sent an angel. For someone hearing me this day, I prophesy that God Almighty will send an angel to your rescue in Jesus' name. That thing that you are believing God for, if people refuse to help you, God himself will send help that nobody can prevent in Jesus' name. Number three, may God roll away every stone blocking your progress. I say it one more time. May God roll away every stone that is blocking your progress. When you look at Matthew 28, verse 2, one more time, it said, when the angel came from heaven, the first thing he did was to roll away the stone. He rolled away the stone because the enemy thought they had finished Jesus completely. What did they do? They first crucified him. As if that was not enough, they wrapped him up in a grave robe. The robe they used to wrap dead people. They put it on him and wrapped him up from head to toe. I pray for you from the bottom of my heart. Every robe of the grave that they are trying to put upon you, may it tear right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Every robe of sorrow that they are trying to clothe you with, may it tear right now in the mighty name of Jesus. And everyone that is beating the drum of sorrow, they are beating the drum of death, expecting you to answer. They are calling your name with the drum of death, expecting you to answer. Somebody will answer in their own house in the mighty name of Jesus. They killed him, Jesus Christ. They put the robe of dead people around him. Then they tied him up. They put a rope all around him, tied him up, tied his hands, tied his legs, and said, even when you wake up, you are going nowhere. And as if that was not enough, they looked for a very heavy stone and they used it to block the tomb. They sat outside and were celebrating that finally they've seen the hand of Jesus. But nobody can see your hand if God says your hand has not come. Just as that angel descended and removed the stone from the tomb, I prophesy over your life. On this special Easter stone Sunday, every stone of obstruction, everybody that has become a wall of Jericho in your life, may God Almighty roll away in Jesus' name. I say it one more time. May God Almighty roll away everything and everyone blocking your progress in Jesus' name. Number four, may God arrest everyone and everything that has become a wall of Jericho in your life. Follow the story of resurrection. First, there was an earthquake. Second, an angel was sent from heaven. Third, the angel removed the stone. Fourth, the angel then sat on the stone, saying, stone, I arrest you. I pray for you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Everyone that is on assignment of evil against you, may the power of resurrection arrest in the mighty name of Jesus. I say it one more time. Everything that the enemy has sent on errand towards you, may God Almighty arrest with the power of resurrection in Jesus' name. You know it is written, he that digs a pit shall fall therein. Everyone that has dug a pit for you, in the mighty name of Jesus, they shall fall into it themselves in the mighty name of Jesus. And everyone that has thrown a stone of evil towards your direction, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the name that is above every other name, may that stone return to the sender in Jesus' name. The angel sat on the stone. He arrested the stone. And the stone could not perform the purpose for which it was brought. I pray one more time. All the messengers of evil, they shall be arrested today in the mighty name of Jesus. Psalm 21 verse 11. Psalm 21 verse 11. It says, they intended evil against me. They imagined a mischievous thing, but they are not able to perform it. They planned it, but they could not execute it. I pray for you, my brother, my sister. Every plan of wickedness that has been put together against you, they shall not be able to execute it in the mighty name of Jesus. All those who have gathered together and have decided to put your name among those that will go into sorrow, they have decided to put your name among those that will be afflicted. I decree in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, they shall not be able to carry out their enterprise in Jesus' name. Number five, the final point for this morning, and then we are going to pray some serious prayers. May God Almighty replace sorrow with joy in your life. If you notice, my brother, my sister, the sermon for the last two or three sessions have been about the same thing. The Lord keeps bringing it to me in different ways. About a week ago, he talked about somebody is about to deliver, that the pain is getting so much The suffering is getting so much, like a pregnant woman that you are about to deliver. Then a few days ago, you will remember, the Lord said, praise in tears. Oh, that it appears you are crying now, outside or inside. It appears things are not growing well right now, but praise God, because something is about to happen. Today, the Lord is saying, people will soon call themselves together to come and see the wonders of God in your life. That's why that point number five says, God will replace sorrow with joy. In Matthew 28, verse 5 to 6, if you go back to it, Matthew 28, verse 5 to 6, it says, and the angel answered and said unto the women, fear not, for I know that you seek Jesus, who was crucified. He is not here anymore. He is risen, as he said. Come and see where he used to lay before. I pray for you from the bottom of my heart. All those who have come to see you in the place of suffering, may God Almighty disappoint them in Jesus' name. The women came to see the body of Jesus so that maybe they can anoint it again. They can just cry and cry and cry and cry. They can just, comfort themselves. They can just go into that sorrow party once again. They came in sorrow. They left laughing and rejoicing. I pray for you from the bottom of my heart. God Almighty will soon make you to receive visitors. Visitors that will come to celebrate with you. Oh, you have been receiving maybe phone calls, or you have been receiving news that are not pleasant. Before this week is over, in the name of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, in the name of the one that raised Jesus Christ from the grave, before this week is over, something new, something great, something mighty will happen in your life in Jesus' name. The women came. They came looking for a dead body. They ended up seeing an empty tomb because the power of resurrection has removed Jesus from the grave. All those who are still expecting, so they just want to call you and say, oh brother, it is well. By the time they hear you singing and shouting hallelujah, what will come out of their mouth will be, oh, I join you to rejoice in Jesus' name. I prophesy, all those who have not yet heard your story, all those who are not able to know, what who have not yet become aware of what the Lord is about to do in your life, when they call to comfort you, you will be the one that will be comforting them in the mighty name of Jesus. You will be the one that will be saying, why don't you come and taste what my God has done in my life? So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. You are going to rise on your feet as we go into prayers. You say, Father, I hold on to the cross of Calvary. You see, the journey began at the cross. It was a painful experience. They put a crown of thorn on his head. They nailed his hand to the cross. They nailed his legs to the cross. They removed his clothes. They laughed at him. They spat on his face. They did all kinds of things to him at the cross. But that was just the beginning of the story. That was not the end of the story. Because the cross is not just a place of death. The cross is a place of power. So you say, Father, I hold on to the cross of Calvary. Let the power of resurrection manifest in my life. Just go ahead and begin to pray to God. I cling to that hold of the cross. Father, let me experience the power of resurrection. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. I rejoice with you that you too will begin to experience right now the power of resurrection in Jesus' name. If you are there listening to this message somewhere around the world, and you have not yet given your life to Jesus, the cross is a symbol of mercy. The cross is a symbol of victory. There's no point trying to struggle through life yourself. The power that can deliver from the grave, that can raise the dead, that power can help you too. So if you are saying, Pastor, I too need a divine encounter. You are saying to God, Lord Almighty, I too need an angel to come from heaven and help me. I too, Father, need every stumbling block in my life to be rolled away. You can just lift up your hands wherever you are and say these words after me. My Lord Jesus, I come to the cross right now. I come to the place of mercy. Please accept me into your kingdom. Help me too to experience the power of resurrection. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. If you have said that prayer, you are welcome to the family of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And I encourage you to please send us your name and your telephone number. You can email it to us at this email address, thelifegate@gmail.com, or you can send it to us via WhatsApp. They will display the WhatsApp number on the screen. Just send us your name and your telephone number and that you give your life to Christ during this service. Somebody will reach you within 24 hours and the power of Jesus will begin, the power of resurrection will begin to work in your life from this moment in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Oh, Father, your faithfulness is forevermore. Thank you, Lord, Father, for your word of life. Thank you, Father, for strengthening your people all over the world. The promise that you have made, Lord, will surely stand. Just as Jesus endured the cross, he tarried in the grave for 3 days. But your promise to raise him up did not fail. Everyone, Lord, that you have spoken words of promise upon their lives, Lord, let that promise manifest in due season. Thank you, everlasting Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. I hope you were blessed by that message. I was. Come and see. And once again, I pray that people will soon gather to come and see the wonders of God, the power of resurrection in your life, in Jesus' name. Amen. So please, let's bring forth our tithe. Covenant Voices will take a hymn, and please just wherever you are, you transfer the tithe into the tithe account. I'll read out the tithe account very quickly. They will also display it on the screen. The tithe account is Zenith Bank 10170463 37. Please transfer your tithe into that account. The fact that we are meeting online is no excuse for you not to honor God with your tithe. And I pray that as you do it right now, God Almighty will open the windows of heaven unto you and will remove every devourer in your life. Please go ahead and transfer the tithe as the choir ministers to us in him. God bless you. Oh, what we say. Amen. 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 We're just going to rise now and also bring forth our offering. The offering account, I'll read that out as well. The offering account is Zenith Bank, account number 10170463320. The account will also be displayed on the screen. Zenith Bank account 10170463320. Please honor the Lord with a worthy offering and dance on this special Easter Day celebration. The Covenant Voices will give us a danceable song where you are right now with your family, with your friends. Just go ahead and give the Lord a worthy dance and a worthy offering. God bless you.
And you are not just a legend, you are a great God. You are God. Say you are God. You are not just ego. You are not just a legend.
You are a great God.
You are God. Just not yet.
You are
a
great God.
You are God, yeah. Hey, you are God.
You are
not just big, yeah. You are not just like
you, yeah.
Say, you are biggie, biggie.
I am very young.
Hallelujah. Say, why are you never mind? big we're in now, Lord. Come on, celebrate Jesus now. Cha 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 cha. Why you no been born like we were in now? Why you no been born like we were in now?
Dedications. We didn't have enough time last Sunday to take them properly. So today there are three babies that we are going to dedicate. And as I call their name and dedicate them in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, they will display their photograph on the screen. So please, wherever you are, just join me in saying amen, amen, and amen. Psalm 127 verse 1 tells us, that except the Lord build the house, they labor in vain that build it. So these children that we're about to dedicate unto the Lord, they came from God Almighty. There's nothing any man or any woman can do to bring a child into the world. And we are grateful that God said yes, and yes, and yes to these three babies that we're about to dedicate. And I pray for as many as are waiting on God for a gift like this. Very soon, we will also be dedicating your own children in the mighty name of Jesus. So I dedicate unto the Lord, Chizara, Chinecherem, Divine, the son of Brother Ogbonaya and Sister Ogechi Dimba. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. We also dedicate unto the Lord, Oluwa Feromi, Deborah, the daughter of Brother Olayinka and Sister Oluyemisi Owolabi, in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. And finally for today, we dedicate unto the Lord, Ayebaifie, Chizara, Ariela, the daughter of Brother Timi and Sister Ndidi, Amaka Asia. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let somebody shout hallelujah! Hallelujah! Today is truly a special day because we also have the joy of dedicating two marriages. So they will also display the photographs on the screen. We also want to dedicate the marriage of Brother Victor and Sister Okafor Azubiene in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. We dedicate also the marriage of Brother Daniel and Sister Charity Uduji in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. For every one of you that you have been dedicated unto God today as a child, the baby dedications, I pray that each one of you will fulfill destiny in the mighty name of Jesus. The Almighty God will abide with you. The favor of God will be with you. The presence and the power of God will abide forever upon your lives in the mighty name of Jesus. As you grow physically, you will grow in the power and in the favor of the Most High in Jesus' name. Every one of you will fulfill destiny. And your mother, your father, each time they hear of you, each time they see you, their hearts will be filled with joy in the mighty name of Jesus. Your entrance into your family will be the beginning of great miracles in the mighty name of Jesus. And for as many of you as we have dedicated today your marriages, may your marriages continue to grow from strength to strength in the mighty name of Jesus. The Almighty God that pronounced upon the first marriage that they be fruitful, I join my faith with yours and declare upon you, your marriage shall be fruitful, you will multiply, you will replenish, you will subdue, and you will have dominion. Everything that you desire in marriage, that and more, God Almighty will grant unto you. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Let somebody shout another hallelujah. Hallelujah. God bless you. Please just listen to the following announcements as we bring the service to a close. We request that please send your testimonies to us via email. The email address is thelifegate@gmail.com. That email address will be displayed on the screen for you. Please send your testimonies to us. I will be happy to read it out during the online service like the one we are doing today. We also encourage you to please become active online. Become active online. The buildings of the church are closed, but the church is open and alive. We are going to have our normal services. We engage regularly. Every day I engage with the church. I send every one of you a word of prayer. I send notes to you. So please engage online. Join us on Facebook. They will display the social media handles of the church right now. So when you go to the Facebook of the church, just click follow. You can also join me on my Facebook. It's Pastor Segun Banwo. When you go there, click follow. And from that point, every day in the morning, you receive a word of prayer from me. And I pray that every one of those prayers will manifest in your life in Jesus' name. We also encourage you to please join us on YouTube. Please, they'll display the address of the YouTube as well. When you go there, just click on the bell. You see a bell, just click subscribe. And once you click subscribe, every time we load a video there of a service, Sunday service, midweek service, or any other service, it will automatically alert you and you go there and watch the service. So please click subscribe. Join us also on Twitter, and you just click follow on Twitter. Join us on Instagram, you click follow. So as many channels as you can, please become active, because this is how church is going to be done for as long as this lockdown is in place. And even after the lockdown is in place, we'll be meeting within the four walls of the church. We'll also continue to meet online on all of those channels. Our three services will continue to hold as usual. The first service on Sunday at 7:30, the second service at 9, when we link up with our Father in the Lord, Pastor Iya Adeboye, and then the third service at 11. So please feel free to join all three services. I'm sure God Almighty will bless you at every service, and your joy shall be full in Jesus' name. A few more, and then we close. Please remember that this is a trying period for most people. Some do not even know how they are going to feed. Some do not know what is going to happen, whether they will have a job, even as this lockdown is continuing. I encourage you to please reach out and just be a blessing to somebody. I remember there are three categories that I mentioned a few weeks ago. Category one is that you really do need help, either because you're an elderly person and you know the elders are more susceptible to the virus, and you cannot afford to go out, even when the period that they have allowed to go out, we discourage you. If you are 60 years and above, we seriously discourage you from going out. So if you are elderly and you do not have a means to support yourself, your family is not in a position to help you, please reach out to your house fellowship. Or maybe you are sickly or you are poor and you really do not have a means of helping yourself at this time. If you do, that's fine. But if you do not have a means at this time, please contact your house fellowship center and they will be providing as much support as they can. That is the category one. Category two are those that you are able to help at this time. Whether you can just pick up the phone and call people, see how they are doing, pray with them, or you have means of supporting them financially, please call the church office and give them your name. Also contact your house fellowship center and we'll be able to tell you how you can be of help to reach out to people or to contribute to the welfare fund. The account number again will be displayed for you. We've been distributing food packs through the house fellowship centers to those who are in real need, not to everybody, to those who are in genuine need that we can verify. So if you would like to also contribute into that pool of funds, please transfer your money to the account number called Welfare, and that account number is Zenith Bank account number 10-15-71-2139. I'll take that again. The Welfare account is Zenith Bank account 10-15-71-2139. As God lays it in your heart, please be a blessing to somebody this season. And then category three are workers in the church. You are a worker, you work in a department, you belong to one department of the church or the other, whether choir or royal guards or Sunday school or children church, and you are in need at this point. You are in serious need at this point. During the lockdown, please contact the church office and contact your coordinating minister. Arrangements have been made to support you all during this period. Very soon, every one of us will gather back in church and will continue to see our faces in the mighty name of Jesus. It is well in Jesus' name. Please remember our midweek service, the night of praise, and that will continue to hold as usual. And then finally, if you have any suggestions, you have any comments, you have a prayer request, please send it to us through the email address, thelifegate@gmail.com. So please, we'll be expecting to hear from you. Just send us your prayer request, send us your suggestions, or send us your comments through those email address. And then first time, as you are joining us for the first time like this on a Sunday, whether you are joining us from Nigeria, you are joining us from America, from London, from Dubai, wherever it is that you are connecting with us, we just want to celebrate you this morning, this day, and we pray that God Almighty will also do a wonder in your life, that the power of resurrection will also be manifest in your life in Jesus' name. And every prayer that you have prayed today and that you will pray, God Almighty will turn it into a mighty testimony in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. I just want to also pray briefly with those of you out there that you've been trusting God for something that is taking so long, or something has happened and you are wondering, God, why me? Why should this happen to me? Beloved, there are the reason for this message. Jesus Christ wondered why God had to take him through such a painful experience. In fact, he said to God in the Garden of Gethsemane, Matthew 26, verse 39, he said, Lord, let this cup pass over me. I don't want to die anymore, Lord. This pain that is coming is too much for me. But the Father, God the Father, did not accept that prayer. And Jesus came to the place of surrender. He said, Lord, not as I will, but as thou will. In other words, Father, go ahead and have it your way. I say to you this day, I don't know what it is you are dealing with, the challenges you are facing, Why don't you also say what Jesus Christ said? Father, have it your way. And I pray that the same way Jesus went from suffering to jubilation, the same way he went from being killed to reigning all over the world, I pray that you too will go from suffering to singing in the mighty name of Jesus. Ecclesiastes chapter 3 verse 11 says, God makes all things beautiful at his time. There is a season for every blessing. There is a season for every divine encounter. Your season will not elude you in Jesus' name. As I was getting ready for this message, somehow, from nowhere, I just found myself singing a song. That song says, he has promised he will never fail. I will follow him. I will follow him. And the Holy Spirit ministered to me, that is a song that should be part of this sermon. So if you are there, you've been waiting on God for a blessing and it appears this thing is taking too long. God is saying you two should sing that song. He has promised he will never fail. I will follow him. I will follow him. Just rise on your feet as we take that song together and just pray. Believe in God that your time of testimony is about to happen. Go ahead and sing that song. He has promised. He has promised. He has promised he will never fail. As I was singing that song, I knew that this is the song for somebody today.
The Lord has a promise for you tonight.
That the promise he has made over your life, that promise will surely come to pass. Go ahead, rise on your feet and begin to declare it. Lord, I know that you have promised. And that your promise will never fail. Go ahead and take that song together with me. Rekele Bumasoto. Rema Sekele Bumasata. Masokele Bumasete. Kele Bumasoto. Kele Bumasete. We adore you.
He has promised.
And we honor you. Your promise never fails. Your promise never fails. Cry to God. Your faithfulness is forevermore. Some time, but God will never fail. God will never fail. God will never fail. Lift up your voice unto Him. Father, you will never fail. 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 Lift up your voice to Him. Just go ahead and begin to bless the name of the Lord. Father, please replace every form of sorrow in my life. The same power that raised Jesus from the dead, Father, let it cause a shaking in my life and let everything work for my favor. Lord, replace struggle, Father, with favor, and let my joy be full. Thank you, everlasting Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. As you have prayed, so shall it be unto you. I declare on this Easter day, this special day that we celebrate the power of resurrection, that the same power that worked in the life of Jesus when He was on the face of the earth, may that power also work in your life in Jesus' name. May God Almighty cause a shaking in your favor. May God Almighty send help from heaven. If people refuse to help you, may God Himself help you in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever stone is blocking your progress, human beings, circumstance, sickness, poverty, whatever is the hindrance blocking your progress, may God Almighty send an angel to roll it away in the mighty name of Jesus. And whoever has been sent on assignment of evil against you, just as the angel arrested the stone, may the angel of God arrest everyone on assignment of evil against you in the mighty name of Jesus. As you go into this new week, you will meet with favor. You will meet with honor. You will meet with joy. Pleasant surprises shall be your portion. And everywhere you go, the power of resurrection will go with you. Everything you do, the power of resurrection will prosper it. In this week, as you live, as you go into it in the name of the Most High God, I pray you will experience a shaking that will lead to a mighty celebration. And so shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. The covenant voices will just lead us in some high praises as we wrap up the service. God bless you. Amen.